Last week, the UK and EU negotiators finally struck a deal, leading to the publication of a draft Brexit withdrawal agreement. The deal covers areas such as citizens' rights, the UK's financial settlement with the EU, and a key point for businesses, the transition period. The draft withdrawal agreement also includes the possibility for the transition period to be extended. Regarding the backstop arrangements, the deal states that the UK would remain in a single customs territory with the EU, while Northern Ireland specifically would continue to align with some EU rules. But it's important to remember that this backstop is really just an insurance policy. The goal of both the UK and the EU is to avoid a hard border in Northern Ireland by reaching a deep and comprehensive free trade agreement, rather than by having to use the backstop. Looking forward, the European Council will meet on Sunday to endorse the deal, and a vote in the UK Parliament is expected to take place sometime in the first half of December. However, there is still considerable uncertainty around whether the House of Commons will vote in favour of the deal. That being the case, businesses must not take their foot off the gas when it comes to Brexit planning. They have to make sure that they are ready for the UK leaving the EU at the end of March next year, whether that is with a deal or without.